What is up? Another part of my little series. And you know what? This might not even last as a series. I just come up with ideas and just do them. No fancy background. One of these days, I'll have a cool little background like everybody has, where their pops are sitting there. I have my pops next to me. Put them over here. I hate pops, but I had to buy the wrestler ones, the luchador wrestlers of Marvel luchadors. Had to buy them, but you just get to see my dog bowls and my DoorDash stuff. But we're not talking about that. We're talking about Rob Liefeld. I always call him Rob Liefeld, so forgive me if I do say that. long time ago, there was a time in the 90s era where Rob Liefeld created Deadpool. Now let's mention that these guys are the young guns of Marvel. They were hot. There's a bunch of them, but like McFarlane, Mark Sylvester, I think his name was, I can't remember. Jim Lee, all these guys were just on fire. Jim Lee was killing it on X-Men. Todd McFarlane was killing it on Spider-Man, and Rob Liefeld was thrown to New Mutants that turned into X-Force. So, Rob Liefeld's claim to fame is creating Deadpool. Now, I'll just let it slide. By the way, he has me blocked on Twitter. And that's not something special to brag about, because he probably blocks everybody. But he created him and Cable with two different writers, I believe. Fabian being, can't remember Fabian's last name, but Fabian's with Deadpool. But the thing is, the Deadpool they created was just a parody of Deathstroke. There was no jokes. He was serious. It was very generic, to say the least. And that was kind of that. New Mutants, what's it? 98 wasn't flying off the shelves. Hope I got that right, or I'll look stupid. Because of these new characters. And these young guns wouldn't have made Image Comics. And with Image Comics, we had Jim Lee on Wildcats, which just was a ripoff of X-Men. We had like Savage Dragon, Spawn, of course, was Tom McFarlane's, and Rob Liefeld did Youngblood, which was god awful. But I guess where you start at is the anatomy, is he just can't draw. I mean, if you look at the Captain America famous picture, he can't really draw that well. He's, and by any means, I'm not an artist at all. But as a fan of art, we could critique all we want and have our own opinions. And my opinion is he's not very good at all. I can't stand that he still gets to do covers. I see covers out there and I'm like, why? This guy gets paid to draw like this. It's almost bad as like Frank Miller's covers as of late. Frank Miller was an icon. Still is an icon, I should say. But the covers are just bad. But Liefeld did his own thing with Youngblood. And the prophecy of no feet started to come up. Smoke covering his feet. Boulders covering his feet. Any characters that had feet they weren't there. And if they did, it looked like a little ballerina slipper. And that was just a no-go. Especially for being an artist, you need to practice that. You need to go home and practice and practice. This is what artists do. If they can't nail things, they practice and they keep trying. And I think Liefeld just says, screw it. This is me, baby. You want me? You got me. So anyways, so time goes on and the trigger snowflake in me was when he was helping out with the Deadpool movies and act like he was super in the know, which I suppose he would be because he created them. And he would kind of brag a little about it. That really annoyed me because he didn't make the Deadpool that we have in the movies today and the cartoons or anything like that, the video games. His Deadpool was dry and it wasn't what it is. Go to Joe Kelly, the writer. He's the one that kind of did the yellow boxes, breaking the fourth wall, the chimichangas, all that stuff. We need to give credit sometimes where credit is due. And that's definitely a place where Rob should not be around. He didn't make Deadpool what he is. But you go to a comic convention, which usually he's very rude there. I think a while back, like 2007, I went and his walls behind him were just covered. He had a big wall, almost like an end cap at a grocery store. And it was all Deadpool. All on his tables was Deadpool. And you think, okay, well, he wants to make money, so he's going to use what makes money. Cool. But again, I hate it because he's making it off of what other people made it famous off of. He didn't do anything except for give him a name and drew him. And I think he was supposed to have like a ripoff Spider-Man costume, if I wasn't mistaken. Or later on, he made a joke that it was supposed to be. But I don't know. Regardless, he made money or makes money off people's success of what they did with Deadpool. So seeing his backdrop at a convention, it's very upsetting and very Al Bundy, living in the past. This is what I did. I don't have nothing else to bring. I don't see any young blood. I don't see like War Child things he's creating on his own. And again, maybe if someone took those over, they could have been famous, but I doubt it. But Deadpool got taken over, and he was going to get canceled at issue 25 of his own series, and fans petitioned for it to, it was that big at the time, for it to continue. It's a great, great run with Ed McGuinness drawing, and I believe it's Joe Kelly writing that one. I highly recommend reading it. It's fun. There's a character named T-Ray in it that is interesting. I always wish they used him in the movies. But back to the movies. So now he acts like he's at the big boy table, which he kind of is. They bring him in, but I don't think he's in there giving it. I can see them going, oh, yeah. Thanks, Rob, for that. But it's all Ryan Reynolds. Ryan Reynolds is the one that gave us Deadpool. He's the one that fought for it. He's the one that wanted it. And I remember the image of just the mask in black and white or something like that, teasing that he was trying to. And it's all on him. Liefeld probably wanted it because he wants some money out of it, of course. You know, you want to get paid. You created a character. But don't act like you're sitting there writing the movie. Because he sits there and acts like he's writing the movie. And I don't care what anyone tells me if they're like, no, he's not like that. Go through his tweets. He always acts like he's got the know. He acts like he's more of a reporter. Like he's got the hot scoop, but he ain't gonna tell you. And I get that, and that's exciting. But you kind of just got to keep it to yourself. Especially that this is a big thing. This is a big budget thing with all the Deadpools. And we didn't see him go like this with Wolverine Origins. That Deadpool was horrendous. But we didn't see him posting and saying they were using his ideas and all that kind of stuff during that movie. But now when Ryan Reynolds got to take over, all of a sudden he's got his big boy pants on and he's doing it and acting like he's part of the gang. And again, I have no doubt that he gets pulled in and out of respect they ask him probably, does this look cool or whatever? Because to be honest, he doesn't write him. I mean, I think now he writes him here and there. But he doesn't really, when he created him, he didn't write him. And he didn't write him the way he's written now. So, it's just a thing that's always bugged me. And it didn't happen until the movie started coming out. And then, I've gotten to Twitter battles with a lot of comic creators, and it's not blacked out for a second. Alright, so it's not to be just a dick to sit there and start beef. It's like, I really care about this character. I don't really understand why you're doing this, or trying to figure out where things are going. And comic creators actually, a lot of them don't let it go over their head. They actually come back and they will argue and fight with you. And Rob Liefeld is one of those. It's not tooting my own horn here to be like, yeah, he banned me, because I assume he bans a lot of people. There's even on record, there's like, I don't know if it's Wikipedia or something, saying like he's one of the most controversial artists or creators. I don't know, he might enjoy being infamous. You might think it's cool being a bad boy. I mean, he did a Levi's commercial during the Image times, I believe. Such a weird time. But he's the kind of guy, like I said, you kind of bark at him a little and he barks back, but then you give your opinion and then he doesn't like it, and then eventually he just disappears. Honestly, I wouldn't even engage with people, because it's like, you're going to have people that don't like things and you might as well just let it go. But no, he doesn't. He wants to argue and he wants to engage with fans, but just not in the greatest way. And I've heard a lot of stories of the way he talks to people and the way he thinks he's a lot better than he is. He thinks he's some kind of comic royalty because of the Deadpool thing. But again, a million times I'll say it, he did not make Deadpool what he is today. Deadpool, what he is today, is thankful to other creators that made Deadpool. He didn't do it. He might have drawn the character, gave him a name, wrote a little bit for him, but he didn't do what these other creators did and gave us the guy that we have on the big screen And then Ryan Reynolds was the one that went further, and he sat there, and he made Deadpool. Deadpool. So it's just one of those things that I have always hated. And I think Rob Liefeld can suck a big coconut. I don't know if I'm going to keep doing these. Who knows? I may just keep doing it. People may never watch them. I mean, I have always had trouble reaching crowds. And that could be me not being good at this. But I enjoy it. I have fun. As long as I have fun, I could keep doing things. And honestly, my wife was going out of town, so I needed stuff to do. And I was like, you know what, I'll just start doing a series of things that have bugged me. But then that brings negativity out, and I'm trying to be positive. But maybe it'll help me get things out that bug me. We already talked about a TikToker, and we talked about now a comic creator. We'll see what's next, what we can go after, or what I'll go after. I actually don't have nothing off the top of my head. I'd actually had to sit there and be like, what pisses me off? Which is a good thing. I shouldn't have a whole huge list off the bat. But that is it. Thank you guys for watching if you did. Again, this may not be a thing forever. I get rid of a lot of my things that I start, and if it has no traction, I just get rid of it. The only thing that stays is the podcast. So the podcast is a thing that we have fun with, and I really, really enjoy. And I hope to grow that more. But that, you know, it's fun. It's good times. But I think people don't want to see fun that much. They want controversy. But anyways, thank you guys for watching if you did, and I just appreciate it if you clicked it, shared it, whatever. Mr. Liefeld won't get to see it, unfortunately. He probably doesn't care. I'm just a peon in this little life. But I got to say my piece and what makes me upset about it, but all hell Deadpool. Thank you for everybody being fans of him, so we got a movie. Movies. Hopefully everybody enjoyed number 3. And with that, I bid you adieu. Thank you.